Well, welcome back to Soulbox. Again, I apologize for going over so long yesterday. I really want to keep these short because I want to keep you coming back. I just want to keep you motivated and interested in the Word of God. Today, we're on day number 10 of our 66 books in 66 days, and we come to the book of 2 Samuel. Now, 2 Samuel picks up after the death of Saul and focuses primarily on the reign of King David. In it, we see the ups and downs of David's reign as king, his military victories, as well as his moral failures and the consequences that follow. As I said yesterday, originally 1st and 2nd Samuel were one book, and of course no author was given for the book. You know, we live in a world where everyone is fighting and trying to work their way up to the top. Whether it's in a playground as a kid fighting for dominance, or in sports fighting for the championship, or at work trying to be on top, trying to be the boss, or in social circles or finances, people are driven to succeed, looking for purpose. They're looking for position, or they're looking for fulfillment. And certainly there's nothing wrong with being the best we can at every single thing we do in life. In fact, we should. Colossians 3:17 says, "And whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through Him." If we're to do everything representing Christ, everything we do represents Him, it should be with excellence. But we have to keep in mind that our goal should not be like that of the world. Our goal should not to be pleasing ourselves, glorifying ourselves, but to please and glorify our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You know, we can rest in God with confidence that as we listen and obey Him, He can promote us, He can lift us up, He can bless us, and He can use us. If we become so focused on getting at the top in our positions, for our own pride and for our own benefit, we will quickly become trapped chasing the wind. Our hearts can become attached to the things of the world, and we can miss out on what God wanted to do in us and through us and the position He wanted to put us in. You know, similar to Joseph's life, David received a dream, so to speak. It was kind of more of a promise. As a young man, David was anointed king by Samuel. Yet at the time that Samuel anointed David, Saul was still reigning as king of Israel. It wasn't till many, many years later that David actually sat on the throne, and it was only after many years of trial and unjust suffering. Certainly the temptation when this happens is to doubt God, become impatient, and even get angry or bitter. You said I was king, and here I am hiding for my life in a cave with no crown. Treated like a criminal and hunted like a criminal. I mean, that could have been what David's response was to all this. It's during these times when we can't possibly understand why everything's happening the way it is. But we need to remember that God is very much at work. We may think we're just waiting on God all the time, experiencing needless suffering and wasting precious time, and yet God is using all these things to prepare us, to mold us, to mature us, and to grow our faith and character. And those things don't come easy for any of us. God can move you. He can move me exactly where He wants to at any time. If He isn't at the moment, then we can rest in Him knowing that He knows what is best for us. You know, our job is to remain humble like David did. Even though God anointed him king, he was nowhere near to being king for many, many years. Yet David refused to disrespect King Saul, and he just refused to harm him in any way, even though he certainly had opportunity to do both. David simply trusted God to do what God said he would do, and he stayed humble. James 4:10 says, "Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and He will lift you up." You know, we can become prideful. We can resist the storms. We can refuse to wait and run out ahead of God and do it our own way. Or wait upon the Lord with humility, understanding that if there is a delay, if there is a hardship, that God is using it ultimately for our good and His glory. Proverbs 29:23 says, "A man's pride will bring him low, but the humble in spirit will obtain honor." You know, God has the ability to raise you and I up to any position He desires. He took a fugitive, Moses, and brought him back to Egypt to lead His people out of bondage. He took Joseph, a slave and a convict and a foreigner, and made him the second most powerful man in all of Egypt, again for the purpose of saving His people. We saw just yesterday how God took a barren woman and gave her a son who would become a man, a great prophet of the nation of Israel. You know, none of these men would have reached the position they did on their own. Each relied and depended on God. Each were put there by God for a purpose, and the purpose wasn't to be filled with pride or fame or riches. Their purposes always served God, and they always served other people. You know, we don't have to waste our energy and our time focusing our way up to the top. We only need to abide in Christ. Stay close to Him, listen to Him, obey His word, walk in His works that He's prepared for us to do. The goal is not to find purpose or fulfillment in our position or in our importance of what we're doing. That should come from God. When our purpose is to please Him, it's to walk with Him, well, then we can be fulfilled along the way. Each day can have purpose. And everything we do, everything we say can be important. We can see God working in and through us and being a blessing to others. Being salt and light and sharing God's love and salvation with a lost world. Doesn't that sound like purpose? That purpose brings glory and honor to God. That brings blessing to our hearts. And guess what? That brings eternal rewards for you and I. So I hope you will look at life and look at your purpose a little bit differently. Find it in Jesus Christ. Find it in following Him. Allow Him to raise you up. Allow Him to be concerned with how important your job needs to be over here, or whether it may seem like something that's not so important over here. You never know how God's going to use you. Don't take for granted any of the opportunities that you have in your life today or any of the positions that God has raised you up to. He's raised you up for a reason. He's going to use you. He's going to bless you. God bless you. We will see you back here tomorrow.